Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Hope you're all staying warm and dry today. Definitely a lot of bad weather going on. Tornadoes. Yeah, I'm sending prayers to everybody. Many of you have been wondering about all these earthquakes in Texas. This is just one small area of the last 30 days of 2.5s or greater. 110 earthquakes. The largest, it looks like, was a magnitude 4.7. That was on the 24th of last month. Yeah, shake map intensity level 5. Yeah, I believe I did a report on that and told them, you know, they better check their water and gas lines. Just about everybody in the area would have felt that one. Some breakage of dishes, windows, and plaster. Disturbance of tall objects. Only 4.6 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. Most people call it fracking. It's actually the disposal of wastewater that's causing these earthquakes. Oh, I went down to the bottom of the list and we got a magnitude 5.4. That was an intensity level of 7. Again, real shallow. 4.3 miles below sea level. That one was 1 month ago today. Yeah, on the 16th of November. Intensity level 7. Everybody runs outdoors. Damage to buildings varies depending on the quality of construction. Notice by drivers of automobiles. 2,277 people said they felt it. That was a felt report sent into USGS. Look at all those felt reports. Oh my goodness. Yeah, let's see here. We got Oklahoma, Houston, Texas, across the border there, New Mexico. Yeah, we got some reports from Colorado. Even up there in Illinois, Kansas. Oh my goodness. Wow. Indiana. It's like, wow. And yet they are still allowed to keep pumping that wastewater into the ground. Here's one of the facilities fairly close to where this earthquake occurred. Let me bring it out for you. Right there. They've had other 5.4s in this location. Let's see. This one was this year. Yeah, the 16th. Oh, they moved the location of where they said it originally happened at. USGS moved the location. Yeah, see all that. Looks like one of the areas where they separate the brine, maybe. Got a truck pulled up to, some of the areas where the, looks like where it's possibly pumped into the ground. For all earthquakes in the last month, there's been 430 of them on this map. 430 in the last 30 days. There was 3. Within the last month of over a magnitude 4.5. Here we got the 5.4. And we also got in the same location, of course, a 4.5. That was on the, yeah, these were all on the 24th. Yeah, and a 4.7. That one, the 4.7, one of them, 30 people said they felt that earthquake. Here you can see how the ground just lifted up. Well, it's not hard to figure out why it lifted up. The 4.5 was the same reason. Look at that. They just have to slow down in how much of that wastewater that they pump into the ground. Yeah, they need to slow it down. And we got some more stuff over here. Yeah, it's really a sparsely populated area. And we need that gas. We need that oil. Yeah, we need it big time. How do you think, the electric cars are charged, right? we are not producing enough energy as it is for all the electric cars that are currently being used. And how do people think they're going to be charged? If everyone is forced to get an electric car, it would probably take decades to produce more green energy, solar or wind generators. Decades. So like I said, people were wondering about all the earthquakes that are occurring there in Texas. Probably 90% of them are man-made. So what are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be prepared for a disaster. Please stay safe. And I will talk to you later. God bless you all.